The race to become Maine's next governor is tight and includes five candidates with interesting and diverse backgrounds. And all this week leading up to the election, News 8's Keith Baldy takes a look at each candidate, their policies and backgrounds in order to help you make a better informed decision. Keith joins us now with more on our continuing commitment 2010 coverage tonight. Keith?
Tracy, tonight we profile Elliot Cutler, one of the three independents running for governor. Cutler entered the race more than a year ago and has spent a lot of time and money running for a position he believes is key to turning around Maine's economy and people's morale.
I'm Elliot Cutler. I'm an independent running for governor.
Nice to meet you.
Hope you'll help me out.
It's a busy day on the shop floor at D&G Machine Products in Westbrook.
I'm Elliot Cutler.
But the perfect place for independent Elliot Cutler to roll up his sleeves and get out his message.
What's your name?
I don't care if you're a Democrat, a Republican, a Green, an independent. I only have two tests. If you love the state of Maine and you want it to work, then let's all sit down and get it done. Make it work.
Cutler says it's his love for Maine, where he was born and raised, that made him enter the race in the first place and decide to spend a lot of his own money on his campaign. He's donated or loaned about $900,000 to himself, according to Maine election records.
We can be a great, great state again, and it's time for that, and I think everyone in Maine feels that way. We all love Maine, we want it to work, and I'm running to make that happen.
And running on his experience and independent thinking. He's not a career politician, as he often tells voters, but has spent plenty of time in and around politics. He started by working for Ed Muskie, the U.S. Senator from Maine. Cutler was then an associate director in the White House Office of Management and Budget and an energy official for President Jimmy Carter. He later started an environmental law firm and lived in China for several years doing legal work there.
These are all things that I did that are going to help me be a better governor of the state of Maine, not only than I otherwise would have been, but better than my opponents will be.
Opponents who have the backing of major political parties, something Cutler does not have. That lack of political infrastructure, money, and an automatic base of voters has created a more difficult road to become the state's top executive and might be a reason for weaker numbers in the polls. But Cutler believes if elected, those challenges will translate into several positives. First, that he will have a clear mandate to lead, and second, he won't have political baggage or enemies.
I think I can work with the legislators much better than my opponents. I mean, Libby Mitchell worked with the Republicans? Please. Paul LePage working with the Democrats? Not now. I think I can work with both.
Work to push for his top priorities, the first of which is to restore people's confidence that Maine is a place open for business and one where people can make a living at a career. On day one, Cutler would sign an executive order to create a special office responsible for making state regulations predictable, certain, and timely. All while trying to revive Maine's economy.
And that means getting the cost of electricity and energy down. It means getting the cost of health care down. It means getting the cost of how we govern ourselves down. We've got to change those conditions and tear down that wall of cost that's keeping prosperity out of Maine.
Cutler says he offers Mainers a choice they don't get with either of the two major political parties. Tomorrow we profile a candidate from one of those, Republican Paul LePage. Live in the newsroom, Keith Baldy, News 8.